For topologists, a coffee mug is equivalent to a donut. Because they both have one hole, a mug can be continuously deformed into a donut and vice versa, as if it is made of clay or rubber. If both a donut and a mug have one hole, how many holes does a straw have? You might say it has two holes, one where the liquid comes out and one where the liquid is sucked in. But imagine if we made a straw shorter, and by short, I mean really short. At this point, the straw looks just like a donut and it clearly has one hole. When we reverse the process, is there ever a point in time where it stops having one hole and suddenly has two holes? If it did, at what point during this process did we ever cover up a hole, reducing the total number of holes from 2 to 1 when all we're doing is continuously shortening the straw? In fact, to a topologist, a donut, coffee mug, and straw are the same. They all have one hole and are said to be homeomorphic to each other because we can continuously deform one into the other. However, a donut would not be homeomorphic to a ball. If we try to continuously mold a donut into a ball by pinching the hole away, there will always be a point in time where it suddenly stops having a hole, so it is not a continuous deformation, and thus a ball and a donut are considered not topologically the same. In the familiar realm of geometry, on the other hand, lengths, angles, and scales all matter, so these triangles would all be different from its point of view. In topology, however, not only are all triangles the same, they are the same as any circle or square, precisely because we can continuously deform them into each other without cutting or gluing, as if shapes are made of infinitely flexible and compressible rubber. This is why topology is also known as rubber sheet geometry. In a moment, we will explore a fun counterintuitive puzzle in topology, but first we'll look at a type of 3D shape known as polyhedra. What do a cube, pyramid, dodecahedron, or any other 3D shape with flat faces have in common? Well, consider how many vertices, edges, and faces each polyhedron has. The cube has 8 vertices, 12 edges, and 6 faces. Counting the values for the rest, this is what we get. Can you find a pattern? As it turns out, the number of vertices minus the number of edges plus the number of faces for each shape is 2. This is called the Euler characteristic of polyhedra. Specifically, 2 is the Euler characteristic of any simple polyhedron, which is just a solid figure with flat faces. But what about a sphere? It doesn't have any flat faces, so what could its Euler characteristic be? To answer that, consider this 3D shape. This is just a simple polyhedron, so it will have an Euler characteristic of 2. When we add subdivisions to the shape, it will still have an Euler characteristic of 2. But as we add even more, the shape will gradually approach that of a sphere. And at an infinite number of subdivisions, this thing will literally turn into a sphere. But we know that regardless of further subdivision, the Euler characteristic remains 2. It appears that a sphere is just like any other polyhedron, but with an infinite number of vertices, edges, and faces. And yet, its Euler characteristic is still 2. Isn't that cool? And this thought process applies to any 3D shape with smooth surfaces that are based on simple polyhedra. As a result, every one of these shapes has an Euler characteristic of 2. And as it turns out, we can continuously deform any of them into a sphere. In other words, if two objects are homeomorphic, then they have the same Euler characteristic. But what about torus-shaped objects such as a mug or a donut? We can compute the Euler characteristic of a torus in the same way we did before by finding a simpler version with flat faces. Take this shape for instance. It has one hole, just like a donut or a mug, but we can now easily compute its Euler characteristic. It has 9 vertices, 18 edges, and 9 faces. That gives us an Euler characteristic of 0. When we add more subdivisions, the Euler characteristic is still the same. However, as we add even more, the shape will gradually approach that of a torus, and with an infinite number of subdivisions, it becomes a torus. And yet, its Euler characteristic is still 0. At this point, it appears that any object with one hole has an Euler characteristic of 0. For objects with two holes, the Euler characteristic is -2. For 3 holes, it is negative 4. In general, an object with h holes will have an Euler characteristic of 2 minus 2h. Now, the puzzle. Let's say there's a very long rod and we have this figure 8-shaped object, let's call it a handcuff, with 2 holes. We can make the rod go through the handcuff in 2 ways. Either the rod goes through only one hole, or it goes through both. Here's the challenge. Can you figure out how to continuously deform one handcuff into the other without removing it from the rod or doing illegal actions like cutting and gluing? Pause the video now if you want to think about it. We've only just touched the tip of the topology iceberg. It can get a lot more complex and mind-boggling than this, and I encourage you to go down this rabbit hole. If you want to learn more about astonishing concepts in topology, I recommend watching my previous video about the mind-blowing and counterintuitive Mobius strip and Klein bottle, which are widely regarded as the poster children of topology. And after that, you can further satisfy your curiosity with Brilliant, which I'm happy to say is the sponsor of this video. Brilliant is a website and app that uses a hands-on approach to learning with lots of interactive and engaging visuals to help you learn math, science, and computer science. It makes use of active learning, which is perfectly tailored to the way the human brain works. Topics include foundational and advanced math, science, and computer science, where they have over 60 courses including algebra, calculus, linear algebra, astrophysics, quantum mechanics, cryptocurrency, and Python programming. I particularly love their calculus courses where I can brush up on topics that I learned in high school. Different from the unengaging and lecture-style learning approach that most schools employ, Brilliant has given me an opportunity to learn this subject in a fun, interactive, and structured way. So if you're currently in school, trying to brush up on technical topics, or simply want to learn something new, then Brilliant is a perfect match for you. Go to this link where the first 200 subscribers get 20% off their annual subscription and to let Brilliant know you came from here. Happy learning, and a big thanks to Brilliant for sponsoring this video.